Hey everybody, it's B, and welcome to another episode of Fine, I'll Do It Friday. And today, I am tackling the other half of my kitchen. Initially, this was just going to be probably about half an hour long of clearing out, you know, pruning my plants, clearing out the leaf debris from the floor, you know, doing a sweep and mop, and replacing on one of my gardens the bottom half of the machine, basically, which just kind of needed a replacement. But then the ADHD got a hold of me, and now I'm going to be rearranging my house. So basically, you're going to witness me moving a bunch of stuff around. So yeah, I appreciate your patience while I get this whole thing figured out. And the whole reason why I'm doing this is, you know, it's a Vlogoween thing, but also, as I mentioned, it is occasionally really difficult for me to do tasks. What was that sound?
Strange.
It is occasionally very difficult for me to just sit down and do tasks when the house is empty. So you are standing in as a body double for me. You're here basically to keep me company while I do my job, while I do the normal things that are required of a human who, like, has a house, you know, gotta take care of the things, I guess. And hopefully it will help you as well, where you're able to hop on, you know, watch this video, have it playing in the background while you two are accomplishing something that you have been putting off for a week, weeks, months, or even years, who knows. And you're just like, you know what, fine, I'll do it. So we're gonna do it together today. So as I did last time, I'm gonna stick my headphones on. I'm listening to YouTube at the moment. I just have a few different YouTube channels that I basically just try to listen to / watch. I don't really watch YouTube, I like listen to it while I do other things, but I basically just try to listen to all of their content that they have available because I really enjoy the way that they talk, the things that they talk about, the jokes that they make, or the commentary that they point to. And you know, that's not always what I listen to while I'm cleaning. Sometimes I listen to music, and sometimes I listen to comfort shows like I Love Lucy or Star Trek. But today it is definitely going to be a social commentary type YouTuber, so in case you were wondering, I guess. For a hot minute, the lighting is going to be a little bit wonky. I guess I could just turn off the lighting for these plants since I'm going to move them anyway. So yeah, I'm gonna do that. I will turn off the lighting for these plants, get them migrated to their new location, and then start cleaning the area. And yeah, I appreciate you. Good luck. Away I go. I am experiencing frustration. But luckily, the resolution to this frustration is undoubtedly on the internet. Time to do some internet research, figure out how to get those light bars off. Kinda need those.
Attach the LED light bars. Identify your light bars. On one side, the camera is at the top. On the other side, the camera is in the middle. Beginning with either bar, hold the light vertically to carefully yet firmly slide the bottom of the light onto the lower blades attached to the lid. To do so, press the pin, rotate the light bar as needed to align the parts, and slide it in. You will hear a small click sound when the light is fully in place. If you need to unplug the LED light bars, make sure your device is powered off. Simply press the pin and gently slide the light vertically to the top.
All right. Push the pin. The pin, by the way, for those of you who don't know, the pin. This is my thumb. This is the hard plastic of the light bar. That's where the pin is. So, it's gonna be an adventure, but hopefully it'll work. Got it. All right, so what you just witnessed, me just like up and leaving, was me getting overstimulated and needing to change clothes. This has actually been my third outfit change of the day, if you don't count like pajamas. So what happens sometimes for me is that a clothing item will be too restrictive, or it will touch me differently than the other clothes that I'm wearing in a way that makes me uncomfortable. Those really nice bicycle shorts that I was wearing are great for me in the mornings if I haven't eaten anything. I have this weird thing with my body where no matter what I eat, I just get bloated. And so as the day goes on, they become tighter, like they become uncomfortable. When I first put them on, they fit. They feel like they fit, and that's it. But then as the day goes on, they start to hurt and start to make me uncomfortable. And then the other thing is, I was wearing a pair of Docs that I am breaking in, and I realized that I'd had them on for about 4 hours and my heels had begun to chafe. And so it's just like, it was a lot of sensations that were uncomfortable, and so I needed to change. I only changed shirts because the one I was wearing was just a little too warm for me. So this one is a crop, it's shorter, and then as you can see, these shorts that I've got on now have like a lot of flex in them. And then down here to my shoes, I'm just wearing my regular house slippers, which is what I normally wear around the house. Thus far, I think it's gone pretty well, taking care of the garden. The downside to the position of the garden right now is that light bar is just obscenely bright. So, it's kind of like that on both sides, but here it's more of an issue. So I'm actually going to be just adding this to the side of the garden to kind of like diffuse that light a little bit, and then we'll be moving on from there, getting that table, those chairs moved over to here, figuring out what to do with these guys. There's a lot more pieces to this than I was like really thinking about when I first started this project, but I'm genuinely having fun. Like, this is actually a really enjoyable experience for me. So this might not be the final place for these guys, these gardens. I might actually move them over by the window. It just kind of depends, but we'll see. I want to get the table moved first and see what I think about that wall over there, how empty it feels or not empty. All right, back to it. I hope you're doing well, and I hope your progress is progressing. Thank you. huge sigh of relief just happened. So my original garden, I guess it was a 2.0, was not turning on. And the whole reason why I had to replace the lid for this other one that you guys watched me do is because it wouldn't turn on. And so I was like over here fiddling with like outlets and being like, oh please no, I don't want to have to put in a claim. Because it took them like 6 weeks to fill my claim when it was like, hey, this isn't working. And it took me like 2 months to actually make the claim because of the, like, I guess, neurodivergent issues. Anyway, huge sigh of relief. That's been resolved. Yeah, so now I'm just kind of like reorganizing stuff. I originally had the gardens, as you recall, on this wall, but I did not like that the lights from them, like the light bars, were shining into both the kitchen and the stairwell. And those lights are just really bright. Good for the plants, bad for human eyes. So yeah, I am pleased with having them over here. They have kind of the added benefit of I can turn the lights off. But they become a set with the plants, and I can sit on this super old chest that I actually plan to go through with you guys in the near future. Found some really cool things inside of that chest. So now I'm just kind of like reconfiguring a few other things. We have this Roomba that doesn't work, that stays plugged in for no reason. And we have another Roomba downstairs that also doesn't work and stays plugged in for no reason. So I need to figure out what to do with those guys because they don't really get used. And I've got this other chest over here that I'm probably gonna put on that wall. Just a few things that need to be moved around and configured, but overall it's looking good and I am satisfied with how things are turning out. I really was not sure how I was gonna feel about this table here. But at present, I am satisfied with it. I want to put some stuff on the wall. And I need to replace the lights, the string lights that we'd originally had, just because they're 6 or 7 years old. A lot of the bulbs are, they don't work. So it's pretty, like, hit and miss on whether or not it'll actually, like, light up an area effectively. So yeah, I'm thinking of putting a new set of string lights just kind of like across the ceiling, like a, I don't know, like a curtain of some kind. I have no idea. There's a word for it, I'm sure. You know what I mean. But yeah, a lot more organizing needs to be done, so I'm just gonna keep working on that until I run out of steam, and then I will switch to working on my laptop. It is currently evening, so I should probably cook dinner at some point before working on my laptop, but we'll get to that in a moment. I would like to complete the tasks that I have signed up to do by undertaking this like huge rearrangement situation. But like I said, I am pretty satisfied. I mean, if you just take a look, ignore the clutter. That is a pretty pleasing sight to see those two there. This light up here, look, I'm renting this house. I hate that light. I hate it so much. It hangs too low, it's in the middle of the area. You know, a lot of people would put a dining room table there, I guess. But even if you do, the table has to take up like a huge amount of space. And I don't like that. So it's just there, and I and my partner being 6'5", frequently run into it. So I also need to figure out where to put the trash can. That's gonna be a bit of a challenge. But we're getting there, we're making progress. All right, let's do a quick tour. Adjusting camera. Okay. So, as you can see, I still haven't figured out where to put my candles. They'll probably just go under with the other candles. That's my cat's toy that rolls around sometimes. I'll turn that off. It's very distracting. All right. Thanks, buddy. Okay. As I was saying, my plan is to hang that guy up. And there we go for that one. The kitchen, it looks cluttered at the moment because I've got, like, cleaning supplies and filming stuff in here. The curtain for here is on the way, and I'm gonna use magnets to secure it so I don't get in trouble with my landlord. And then over here, we have our new garden area. So garden number one has been fixed. This is gonna be turned into a nursery for my new, seedlings, which I will make another video about. This chest we are gonna go through. There's some really cool stuff in there. I've got all my little gnomes. Little gnome guys. And then we've got garden number two, which I did not end up pruning. I will though eventually. And garden number two will serve as the new place for these guys once they reach the point of maturity where they can move over to here. These also work for sticking plants in. I've got my little, I don't know, ofrenda altar situation here. There's my salt, just an assload of salt because yay pots. And then I haven't really figured out what to do with this guy and the cookbooks and stuff. They're just gonna hang out in there for now. I might actually move the cookbooks to underneath that table when I clean it out, like clear out the underneath. Yeah, so that is the new setup. Trash can's here for now. And I've got my little orange packet above to keep the smell away. And this is the other chest. I want to put it somewhere other than right next to the trash can. But I haven't figured out where, and this is the next area of the house that needs to be addressed. So when I do address this area, I'm sure I will find a space for this chest. And then I have some things that need to be put away, but otherwise, I think I am done for the day. So that was a lot of productivity. Like, that was a very, I'm gonna say, effective, fine, I'll do it Friday, where I have done quite a bit more than I anticipated I would, but I think for the better, in terms of just moving this dining area into the kitchen and moving the plants out into this area where they have more light, like more general sunlight. And just kind of freeing up space in that area for existence and for the cats to play and things like that. So I'm going to sign off now and switch on over to working on my laptop. I hope that this was a useful final Do It Friday for you. I know it was a long video, but hopefully that means that you and I both got a lot accomplished. I appreciate you, and, you know, all of the normal things, like, comment, subscribe, share, and soon enough, probably at the beginning of November, I will do an official poll on whether or not, like, on what our official channel name should be. Who are my subbies? Are you Lettercast Clan, Jackalope Tribe, Page Turners, who shall you be? Who shall we be? But in the meantime, this is all I got, so see you next time.